Have you ever come back from a vacation with a nice camera full of great shots, do you think? And you're taking a look at them and you see something like this over here, somebody kind of sticking into your picture frame like that and ruining the picture? Happens to everybody, happened to me right here, up here at Lake Havasu. So let's take a look at how to fix this. I'm George Pearson, and in this Photoshop Elements video, we'll be using some standard tools in here to remove this person over here on the left-hand side. I was just up at Lake Havasu for a family get-together and took just a little bit of time out to take a few pictures as well. Most of it, spent with the family, of course, but did take some time for a few shots, and there's part of my family. There's my brother-in-law kind of poking in here on the left-hand side of the picture. Let's go ahead and get him out of this shot. Now, the first thing I usually will try on a picture is to come in, make selections, and try using the content-aware fill to take it out, and oftentimes it's a great way to quickly fix a picture. In this case, it doesn't work. There's just too much busyness in here for that to work out well. So we need to do this the hard way using the clone stamp tool. I'm just going to take all these layers here, just trash all that stuff and start off with a brand new clean file right down here. And if you want to practice with this exact same file, there is a download link for this picture and you'll find that in the description. Okay, let's zoom in. And we'll start off at the top and then just work our way down. The first thing, of course, here is the hand right there. I'm not sure exactly what he was saying in here, but he was talking about the bridge. Now, this is a good spot for some clone stamp work. We'll just copy some stuff over here and paste it in that area and see if we can make a nice clean effect in here. So go to our clone stamp tool there. And you can see here's the size of the brush. There it is. And that color in there, that's just showing some of the color from the last place I was clone stamping from. If I move it around, notice how it kind of shows different areas behind there. So the way you work with this is you find where you want to copy from, hold the Alt key down, you get this little kind of a target, and then click on that spot, and then let go and move over and clone where you want to clone to. Now there's a little bit of a line right here, so I can kind of see this, a post right here. There's a post right in there as well. In the door just to the right of that, we can use that bit in here and start with that to fix this area right in here. That should be a pretty good fit. Now notice also the size of the brush. You can make the brush size larger or smaller. I'm going to take this and just dock this into position. There we go. You can make the brush size larger or smaller, of course. Right down here, there's your size. And I normally like using a soft brush. What I'll do is I'll just grab a standard soft brush in here. I got 65 right there, and then I'll bring the size down. Either use the slider control right here, or use the left or right square bracket keyboard shortcut. Left goes smaller, and the right goes larger. I normally do that, it's just real fast. Now, because this post is right up against a window here, and over here it's kind of in front of the window, with a little line right there, I think I'll grab this post here first and just get just a piece of that in. Let's go ahead, we'll do that. But I'll come right down here where the post crosses over the base and we'll grab this spot in here. Let's just make our brush size a bit larger until it's just a bit bigger. And that's pretty good right there. Okay, hold the Alt key down and I'll click right here. Now you can see where I'm copying. See what's copying from right there? And that's under the clone overlay, and I'm showing the overlay right there. That's why we're seeing that. What you can do is you can then match that up with what you want to cover. So it's right in line right there with that horizontal line, and I'm right down below that post, which is straight up. Just click down and then hold, and you can begin to clone that in. Let's just see what that looks like. It's okay for there. A little dark maybe, but it's all right. We can keep on going down here. It should be fine for this bit right in there. That's okay. Let's now go back to the door here. And I'm going to come right up here to the upper left-hand corner on the door. I want to just find a spot that's easy to find. So Alt and click. And let's go right over here. Match that corner up. Click and hold. And then let's paint in from that spot. I can then fix that wall bit right in here. And let's get as much of that door in as we can. There we go. It's a process of going back and forth and finding good spots to make this work. Now we're beginning to get a little bit of the edge of this post over here. So at this point, I need to have some of the door here brought down below. And this will be a couple of spots to do this, a couple of steps. So I'll go right here again, grab the Alt key, find a nice edge right there, click, let go, come down and match that. And I'll just put on just a little bit of that. And I'll come up and I'll do it again. And take it down. That should take it right down to that edge. And that looks pretty good. Okay, now let's take some of this post over here. I'll come right into the edge of the post right there again. Alt and click. Bring that straight down. And we can use that to fill in that section. And that's looking pretty good. So it's just a matter of going back and forth like this and grabbing little pieces until you slowly fill in and remove what needs to be removed. There's a little bit of a post right here which is wrong, so I'll grab some of this wall color right there and just cover up that post. That's looking okay. Just a little bit more right there. A little bit in there, I just want to get rid of that. I'll just grab something over here. So you need to maybe look around till you find just the right spots and go back and forth and just clean that out. Just a little bit of work and you can get the whole thing nicely taken care of. Okay, now it should be pretty easy. I'll just grab some of this. Let's go over this side. I'll grab right here. Pull it straight over and let's just bring that in a little bit. That's a little high. So let me just bring it down just a touch in here. Make sure our alignment looks good. That's fine. And let's bring this side in as well. Just if those meet up in the middle. There we go. And the rest now is pretty straightforward. I think I'll take this thing here and stick it over the handle, go right to this spot there. And then just bring that in. And we should be able to copy that in and get most of the rest of that hand cleaned out, and that should match in nicely. Okay, so the hand's taken care of. Now let's move down. It gets pretty easy down here. Let's just bring our brush size up again. When you're working in a textured area like this, and it's an outside area, there's a perspective on this. You'll find that these are smaller dots. There's kind of a horizontal lining there. If I scroll down, they get further and further apart. So the idea here is that you want to clone left and right as much as possible. You want to clone from over here to put over here. You can move down, but you want to be cloning from the left to the right-hand side, or from the right to the left, depending upon what the picture requires. So I'll go right over here, and a little Alt right there. Just pull it straight across, and let's come in and take out the rest of that hand. Same thing again. And just work back and forth until you've cloned out the rest of the image. That's the edge right there. That's good. And again, trying just to pull it straight to the left, if at all possible. A little tricky right in here because of that bush. There's nothing over here to use. So let's get it as close as we can. Maybe bring it down just a little bit here. And just take it as far as we can. It's also a good idea to move your clone stamp around a bit so you don't begin to have any repeating pattern happening. You see a repeating pattern like this thing right here and there, just grab something else somewhere else and clean some of those out. Now whenever you see that little crosshair, that means that I'm holding down the Alt key at that point. Okay, it's come down a bit. Let's try to work in here. Now there's that bush. I went too far on that. Let's come down here, try to stay away from that bush if possible. Swinging a little bit above, it's not directly straight across, but sometimes you have to compromise just a little bit depending upon what's around the image. That's why this didn't really work with the content-aware fill, mostly because of that bush right there that was causing all kinds of problems. Once we're past that, it's pretty easy to just come in here and very quickly finish the rest of this off. As you can see, that's all going very nicely. Again, just going from the left out here, a nice clean spot, and then over there towards the other side. Now, once we're down here, there's a bit of a problem. As you can see there, we have this chain that ends up being out in the middle of nowhere. We'll have to fix that. We'll get everything else fixed first. We'll then come back and deal with that chain. There's a special little trick for things like that. Works out very well. But first, clean everything else out. Just about through with this one. It looks like there's a lot of messiness in here, and that's because, of course, we're really zoomed in tight on this. Okay, down here, I'll come right down to this spot here. Again, hold the Alt key down and click there. You can see here very easily how I can match up the spot on that line and then paint right from that line. And then hopefully things will match up exactly and no one will ever see that. Also, if you're working with lines like this, it's a good idea to do separate selections each time for each line to make sure that things stay nicely lined up. Now this one goes at a down angle, so I'll have to pull this down a bit this direction here to match that angle, and it may take a couple of movements there to get it in, and that looked fine. This part's easy. Just grab some of this in here. There we go. I'll grab some of this coloration, kind of like a line right there, and just about done. A little bit of that, and there we go. Okay, at this point, my brother-in-law is gone. Let's put the fit screen. There he is. All gone. Everything looks great back here. It's real small, of course. You don't really see anything on that, so it's a nice fix in there. Last thing to do on this, then, is to fix this bit of chain. Now, notice that the chain has a slow curve happening in here, so I can't easily just copy up here and put it down here. It's going to get kind of a strange bump happening in there if I do that. I need to actually rotate that around a little bit. Now, I'll do that by doing a copy. I'll grab the lasso tool here. This is the polygonal lasso tool, but any lasso tool is fine. And I'll just select a piece of this, and I'll come right here to an intersection of that chain. I'll grab that bit, go up to Layer, come down to New, Layer via Copy. I can now pull that over. There's my new copied layer with that chain. Now, I can't really see what I'm doing because that little pop-up is in the way, so I'll just use my arrow keys, the cursor keys on the keyboard, and let's back this chain in until it fits in nicely, right like that. Now it's a little bit of the wrong angle, so I'll use the Control T keyboard shortcut and then to spin it just a little bit like that. Choose OK, and then again the arrow keys on the keyboard to put that back into place, and that fixes that bit of a curve in there. Okay, same thing down here. Make sure you go back to your original background layer. Grab the polygonal lasso tool and let's make a lasso around this. There we go. Same thing, layer, new layer via copy. And pull that over. And once again, I'll get my cursor out of the way, and let's just find a good spot with the arrow keys, and that matches pretty well. Maybe just a little bit of a rotation, so again the Control T keyboard shortcut, just a little bit of a rotation on that should be enough, and tap that back into place with the up arrow, and there we go. Okay, now because we've been working on the original back in here, I've made some changes on this. Make sure you don't save it back to the original file. Now, it won't save anyway because I have layers in here. It will automatically save to a Photoshop file. Let's do a Save As. Do File, Save As. Here's my PhotoFix folder with all my other Photoshop files in here. Okay, it's automatically doing a Save As to the Photoshop PSD file format, again, because it has those layers. But I also want to change the name right now. I'll just call it Remove Arm, and let's give it a bit better name here. Lake Havasu, that's Arizona. There we go, Lake Havasu, Arizona. Remove Arm, PSD file, and save. It's now protected. It's not overwriting the original file, so I can go back to my original if I need to or I want to for any reason. We've now fixed this image in here. Okay, let's put this back out to a fit on screen. There we go. And my brother-in-law has been nice and cleanly removed from this picture. In case you're curious, this is that infamous London Bridge that was actually shipped over from England over into this resort town along the Colorado River in the Arizona desert. So there you go, London Bridge in the middle of Arizona, out in the middle of actually nowhere really, but there it is, pretty nice resort. Okay, let's take a look at this. Let's see how this works. I'll put this one right here. Let's stretch it out just a little bit and a little bit of a zoom on this. That should be good enough. Let's find that file. Recently edited, and that was this one right down here, 7754 on my numbering scheme. There we go. Let's make this a little bit larger again as well. They should match size now. There we go. So there it is with my brother-in-law, and here it is without, using that clone stamp tool to clean up and remove that person out of the photograph. So if you have a nice picture with just one or two little flaws in it, it's easy to clean those up here inside of Photoshop Elements. Now, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button and of course share, and also if you really want to learn how to use this program, not just the one or two tools we were using here for this cleanup, but all of the tools, all the menus, all the panels, everything, look at my complete training for Photoshop Elements, and there's a link for that right down there in the description. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you found it useful. If you like this video, click on the like button below to let others know. You can click the subscribe button so you don't miss any of my videos in the future. I'm frequently uploading new training videos. Don't forget to check out my website at howtogurus.com.